A place for you and your friends to hang out, a Mac sticky notes app, and a dog-focused productivity timer. They're the new three apps we're going to be diving into in this week's New Apps Breakdown. I might need to work on the name. I feel like that's awful, but if you have any suggestions, feel free to comment below. So this week, we're going to be diving into some apps that you can download and explore that I've checked out this week and I think are worth some of your time and attention. Today's video is kindly brought to you by Sensama. If you're interested in getting your daily planning in control, check it out below. It's great. I've used it for many years and we'll tell you a little bit more about it later in this video. So the first one on our list is Over on the Mac. Now, there are actually quite a few apps that do sticky notes on Mac. Now, there are a few like Stickies and SideNote, which are a little bit more structured. I'll include those below if you've not checked those out. But I checked out one recently called Float, and it comes with, I guess, a slightly different approach. So you get three types of the note you create. I think it's a green one, pink one, and a blue one. And what you can do is create these sticky notes to appear on top of stuff and around your Mac OS. Now, it's really nice because you can click into them, start customizing. They have three fonts and little different font sizes, three different sizes, so small, medium, large, and you can just put them anywhere on your screen. Now, you have to click into them to get them off away, so there's no worry about closing them quickly, and you can even shake them about and they have this little light animation. Now, what's nice about this app is you can actually download it. I believe it's $5 or $6 with VAT as a minimum price, and you get access to it lifetime. So that is one of the benefits of it. You can choose higher if you think the developer should get more, but that's the lowest price you can get it for. You can't really just get it for free, but at the same time, that's a fairly good value, I think, in terms of what you get. So you can turn any of your notes into lists or to-dos, and it's a simple one for Mac. So next up is one that I checked out for iOS. I've actually been keeping an eye on this app for quite a while now. I feel like social media is so busy, so noisy, and sometimes those communications with friends can be really difficult. And this app's called Abode, and it's like a dedicated area for you to join with your friends where you can play games, keep people write data on notes, share images, and have a collaborative to-do list. Now, the reason I like this is because I used to like an app called Path. Now, back in the days when Path was out, it was quite hard to convince those people to join Path and actually do it. So hopefully I don't have the same problem with this, but I quite like that there's a dedicated environment for you to do things. So I might consider using this with my partner, and the games are quite fun to interact with. I probably won't be playing them because we got kids and they'll just be all over them anyway. But at the same time, I like the idea of the collaborative to-do list that you can share. Pinning photos is quite a nice idea, and being able to take notes in one place, as well as chatting as well as a sort of dedicated app. So I'll be keeping an eye on Abode. It's incredibly well designed, and I'll see if I use it with my wife. So today's video is sponsored by Sensama. Sensama is a powerful, mindful task management software, and it's really popular for those who want to stand back and plan their day more effectively. There's guided planning, reflection upon each of the days that you complete, and great systems in place to help you focus, but also make sure you're not stuffing your calendar and task management with lots and lots of tasks. So check out Sensama below, and thanks for those ties for sponsoring today's video. So for the dog focused productivity timer, I'm sure you've all been waiting for that. This app is called Focus Dog, and I actually found it on Android. Yes, I have an Android phone. People typically don't know that I actually have one. I don't have it as my main driver, but I have one. It's somewhere here. So I can show it on screen. And this Focus Dog timer is a very simple concept. You start your focus and then you earn a donut for your dog. And essentially, then the dog gets it, happy days, but you earn donuts and they're all sort of like gems that you can collect. The gems work towards getting a meal for real dogs in real life, sort of like how Forrest does it with planting trees. But there are loads of other gamification elements of this, like the ability to see sort of like a GitHub chart of how many commits or habits or tasks that you've done, and focus timer, which is really nice, as well as loads of other statistics. It's sort of a gamified way of doing it. There's also a premium mode, which has Pomodoro timer, cheating mode, which is essentially you can use to skip the streak and make sure that you can recover your donuts. But a very cool app that's highly rated on both iOS and Android. The upgrade to the premium is, I believe, starting from $1.99, although include pricing over on Toolfinder. So those are the new apps of the week. If you have a better name for this series, please do let me know. I'm trying to make it recurring showing you some cool apps I think are worth downloading. So thank you so much for stopping by. If you find tools that you want to explore, or you want to find tools you want to explore, jump over to a site called toolfinder.co. We run it and we help you find the best tools in the productivity tool space. So do check it out and feel free to check out all the apps we mentioned today below. Thanks very much, and I'll talk to you all very soon, I'm sure. Cheerio.